Hello guys, good morning one and all. In yesterday's lecture, we have seen the introduction of the material handling system. What is meant by material handling system? Then again, we have seen the system concept for the material handling. Then we have seen the objective of the material handling system. Also, we have seen the classification of the material handling system, and last is a guidelines in selecting in the material handling system. In today's lecture, we'll going on the types of the load or classification of the load handled by the material handling system. There are two types of the load: unit load and bulk load. Unit load, what is mean by unit load? Unit load is a rigid single mass, okay, which is handled by or transported as a one piece. It is known as a unit load. What is the example of the unit load? Component of machine, complete machine. Again, we can say the different types of the boxes, okay, or containers, building blocks, etc. Okay, this is coming under the unit load. You have to consider as a one piece, or we can consider the rigid single mass is known as a unit load. Then second type is bulk load. What is the bulk load? Bulk load consists of a large number of homogeneous particles, large number of homogeneous particles, or we can say the lumps of any material. Okay, lumps of any material, or we can say the powder. Okay, it is known as a bulk load. Bulk load consists of a large number of homogeneous particles or lump sum of any powder or any material. Okay, remember that. What is the example of that? Coal is there. Different types of the minerals are there. Ore are there. Okay, sand, then stone, clay, cement bag, okay, all these things are coming under the bulk material. Then next thing is a containerization. What is mean by containerization? Sometimes in the examination you will get the note on the containerization. Containerization is nothing but the process of converting the bulk load or small unit into the unit load. Okay, this by using the containers, different types of the containers is known as a containerization. It is the process of converting the bulk load into the small unit, or we can say the bulk load or small unit into the unit load. You have to convert the bulk load into the unit load using the container is known as a containerization. You have seen in the some factory or plant, it is inconvenient to handle the bulk load. Okay, in addition to it is highly inconvenient and uneconomical to treat the small size of component, or we can say the product of a unit load in a material handling. That's why we require the containerization. The containers of there is a different size and shapes are used for the handling the bulk load as well as a small size product or component. Okay, all of you getting? For example, cement or cement bag, okay, or bearing in boxes. What is the consideration in containerization? Okay, when we use the containerization thing, then you know the different consideration we want to the consider. There you have to consider first, limit the number of containers. There is a, as per the size and shape, okay. Limit the number of containers as per the size and shape. Second is a, design the container size, shape based on the load to be handled. Okay, what type of the load you will be handle? This is design the container size and shape. Then size of that container, taking into account the space availability in material handling equipment. You have to check what type of material we have handled and what is the space availability in the container. Okay. Then design that container for stacking arrangement. Okay, design the container for stacking arrangement. Then design the container for flexibility and minimize the utilization. Okay, keep the container as painted. Why painted? Because we want to identify which type of material we'll transport. Okay, means we want to give the color code the containers by function. Okay, but there are different types of the function. Okay, as per that function, you have to coloring that containers. Okay, then there are again two types of the container. Preferred, we want to the preferred any one type of the container. There is a, first is a wire mesh container and second is a steel container. We'll prepared any one. We'll prepared wire mesh container. Why wire mesh container? What is the reason behind that? There is a wire mesh container are we can say the this container are a self-cleaning. Okay, this container are a self-cleaning. Okay, wire mesh container are a self-cleaning. Then next, what is the advantage of the wire mesh container? When parts are dropped into the container, then we'll get the less noise as compared to the solid steel container. Okay, we'll get the less noise. Use for washing part without removing them from the container. No need to the remove the part from the container. You can wash as it is. Okay, and this part will be dry and cool faster than the steel container. That's why we'll prefer wire mesh container. Okay, all of you getting what is the use of the wire mesh container and steel container as compared to the we'll use the wire mesh container. What is the containerization and what is the consideration in containerization? You have to know this. Then next is the next thing is a belt conveyor. Okay, what is the use of the belt conveyor? First, see, to transport the product in straight line, or we can say the horizontal or inclined direction or path from one spot to the operation, one spot of operation to the another spot of the operation. Okay, this is the use of the belt conveyor. This items with the irregular surface and for the small item and for the small item. We'll see the one by one. Okay, I have shown here one figure. There are different components are given. Before going on that, see, you know types of the material handled by the conveyor. There are two types of the material we have seen. Unit load, unit material and bulk material. Okay. But here four types of the material we can handle by the conveyor. Bulk material. In the bulk material, there is a kegs of different size and shapes. Or we can say the granule of the different sizes and shapes. This bulk material coming under the minerals, coal, sand, stone, clay, cement, powder, material, etc. Okay. If you want to the transport the hazardous material, this hazardous material is explosive substance, or we can say the that mixture which cannot be handled by the hoist or elevator. Why? Because of due to the potential risk of the explosion under the impact. That's why we can't transport that hazardous material by the hoist or elevator. We want to the use the conveyor. Then if you have the loose material, third type is a loose material. In process there are small parts like nuts are there, bolts are there, casting, forging, plastic parts are there. This loose part also we can handle by the conveyor. Okay, and fourth is a packages. There are different types of the packages or different types of the boxes are there. फॉर एग्जाम्पल प्लास्टिक बॉक्सेस, वुडन बॉक्सेस और ड्रम एक्सेट्रा, ऑल दिस कमिंग अंडर द पैकेजेस. देर आर सेवन टाइप्स ऑफ द कन्वेयर. फ्लैट बेल्ट कन्वेयर इज देयर, देन ट्रप बेल्ट कन्वेयर इज देयर, ब्लैंकेट बेल्ट कन्वेयर, वोवन वायर बेल्ट कन्वेयर, चेन कन्वेयर, एप्रॉन कन्वेयर एंड स्क्रू कन्वेयर. ओके, देन सी हियर इज दिस फिगर इज गिवन. देर आर डिफरेंट कंपोनेंट्स आर गिवन. कन्वेयर बेल्ट इज देयर, कन्वेयर बेल्ट इज देयर, देन हेड ड्राइव पुली इज गिवन. ओके, एंड टेल पुली इज गिवन. दिस इज द टेल पुली एंड दिस इज द ड्राइव पुली. ओके, देन स्नब पुली आर गिवन, आइडलर्स आर गिवन. दिस इज द स्मॉल आइडलर्स, रिटर्न आइडलर्स एंड फॉरवर्ड आइडलर्स आर गिवन. ओके, दिस इज द स्नब पुली और वी कैन से द स्नब आइडलर आर गिवन. ओके, बेल्ट कैरिंग आइडलर आर गिवन, बेल्ट कैरिंग आइडलर आर गिवन. ओके, देन बेल्ट टेकअप डिवाइस इज गिवन, टेंशन टेकअप डिवाइस. दिस इज द बेल्ट टेकअप टेंशन डिवाइस इज गिवन. देन देयर इज अ फीडर यूनिट इज गिवन, फीडर यूनिट, एंड दिस इज द डिस्चार्ज यूनिट गिवन. वील सी द डिटेल्स वॉट इज द यूज ऑफ दैट कंपोनेंट वन बाय वन. ओके, देन सी हियर विल आई विल शो द फिगर. विद द हेल्प ऑफ दैट फिगर वी कैन आई विल एक्सप्लेन. सी फर्स्ट इज अ फर्स्ट, वेर इज द फर्स्ट पॉइंट पार्ट. दिस इज द सर्कुलर पार्ट. This is called as a head pulley or drive pulley. Okay, what is the use of the head pulley or drive pulley? First, remember that it is the head pulley is coupled with the drive unit. Okay, this is the totally drive unit. This head pulley is coupled with the drive unit and this drive the belt conveyor. This is the belt. Okay, this drive pulley drive the belt conveyor. This is located at the head end of the conveyor. Head end. This is the head end of the conveyor. This is located at the head end of the conveyor. Okay, all of you getting the what is the use of the drive pulley? Drive pulley is coupled with the drive unit and drive the belt conveyor. And it is located near to the head end. Okay, then second is a tail pulley. Second point is a tail pulley. This is the tail pulley or tail end is there. This is located at the tail end. Okay, and this belt conveyor run over the head and tail pulley. This belt conveyor are run, or we can say run over the belt head pulley and tail pulley. Okay, all of you getting the where is the location of the head pulley and tail pulley and what is the use of that? Then third is here snub pulley. Snub pulley. What is the use of the snub pulley? It is used for the changing the direction of the conveyor belt. If you want to the rotating anti-clockwise or clockwise direction, then we are using the snub pulley. This snub pulley is used for the changing the direction of the conveyor belt. Conveyor belt. With the help of that snub pulley, you can change the direction of the conveyor belt. This is known as a snub pulley. All of you getting? Then belt carrying idler or roller is there. Okay. Belt carrying idler or return idler or roller. Check that. Belt carrying idler shown on the number 4. And return idler, this is shown at the bottom of the belt. Okay, this is the 5 number. This is the return idler of roller. What is mean by idler first? Idler are used for the supporting the conveyor belt. Supporting the conveyor belt on upper run as well as lower run. Check that. Upper run, where is the belt? Here is the belt. Okay, below that belt, there is a belt carrying idler or we can say the roller, and here is a return idler at the bottom side of the belt. That's why idler are used for supporting the conveyor belt on upper run as well as lower run. Remember that. Okay, there is a belt carrying idler. First is a this is the belt carrying idler. This is the supporting the upper run of the belt. And what is the return idler? Return idler is supporting the conveyor belt on lower run. Where is the lower side? This is the lower side, and this is the return idler that are supporting the conveyor belt on lower run. Okay, all of you getting what is the difference between the belt carrying idler and return idler, and where is this located? Okay, then next one is a bend pulley is there, sixth number. Check here, bend pulley is used when you this bend pulley are used at the where is the location of the bend pulley? Check that, where we have the take up tension device. Okay, there we are using the bend pulley. Where we want to the bend the belt, there we will use the bend pulley both side of that belt at take up tension device. There we are using the two pulley. Okay, sixth number, this is called as a bend pulley. Then seven number is a take up pulley. Okay, here we are using the one is the take up pulley. Okay, see, then next is a belt take up device. Okay, this belt take up device is attached to the this take up pulley. See that this what this will be do this. Okay, this unit is called as a belt take up device. Means there are two bend pulley and one is the take up pulley, and that take up pulley is attached to the some wet is there. Okay, eight number is a counter wet is there. Why this wet is attached? Because sometimes what happen, belt will be loose. Okay, then at the time of that, maintain the adequate tension in the conveyor belt. That's why we require the belt take up device. You have to maintain the adequate distance. That's why we require the belt take up device. Otherwise, sometimes belt will be slip. Then next one is a check that feeder unit is there. 12 number. 12 number is the feeder unit. What is the use of that feeder unit? It consists of feeder and hooper. Okay, feeder and hooper. Hooper is 13 number is there. This feeder is connected to the hooper, right? And it is used to the loading the material. If you have load the material on the belt, then you have to place that material in the hooper. Then this material is coming in the feeder, and this feeder is connected to the belt conveyor. Okay, belt conveyor. This material is automatically placed on the belt. Okay, with the help of feeder unit. Then next is a discharge unit. Where is the discharge unit? Here is a discharge unit. Okay, when the belt is moving, then here we'll get the discharge of the material. Okay, it is used to unloading. When you loading the material with the help of hooper and feeder, then where will discharge this or unloading this material? With the help of discharge unit. Discharge unit is used to the unloading the material from the belt conveyor. Okay, from the belt conveyor. And last is a drive unit. This is the drive unit. Okay, then this drive unit is used to the driving the head pulley. Drive unit is used to the driving the head pulley. Okay, then nine number, check that here is a nine number is a belt cleaner are given. Here is the nine number. Here is a nine number is there. belt cleaner are given. Okay, sometimes what happens when you transporting the material, then there is some substances is there or some liquid is there, then how to clean the belt? With the help of belt cleaner, or it is also called as a scraper is there. Scraper is there. Okay. Internal belt cleaner is there also. See, inside, in between that upper run of the belt and lower run of the belt, here is a belt cleaner is there. This belt cleaner is called as a internal belt cleaner or scraper is there. This is used for the again cleaning purpose. Cleaning purpose. Okay. Belt conveyor is there. 11 number belt conveyor. What is the use of a conveyor belt? This is the endless belt. Okay. There is no end of that belt. It is used for the carrying the material from the one end to the another end. This is the use of the conveyor belt. You have to carry the material from one end, means which end? Feeder end or hooper end, okay, where we feed the material. And second is the another end is a discharge end. Discharge end. This is the use of the conveyor belt. Okay, all of you getting what is the use of the conveyor belt? Yes, this is the conveyor flat belt. You should remember that 14 points. Okay, first is a conveyor belt head. Head pulley or drive pulley, what is the use of a tail pulley, snub pulley. Snub pulley, it is used to give the direction of the belt conveyor, okay. Belt carrying idler or roller, okay. This is, idler are used for supporting the conveyor belt, right. Then return idler or roller are there, again, forward and return is there. Then bend pulley is used when you bend the belt. Okay, at the time of the take-up tension device or belt take-up device, there we are using the bend pulley. Then again, there is a take-up pulley is there. Okay, this take-up pulley we are attached to the counterweight. Counterweight. Okay, because of we'll get the maintain the adequate tension in the conveyor belt. That's why we require the this. Counterweight and take up pulley. Then there are two belt cleaner or scraper is there. Okay, one is called outside belt cleaner and another one is a internal belt cleaner is there. Scraper, we can say the scraper. Then there is a conveyor belt. This is the endless belt. Okay, feeder is there, hooper is there, and different types of the material are there to transporting the material from one place to the another place. Okay, all of you getting what is the flat belt conveyor? This is the first type of the belt conveyor. This is the first type of the belt conveyor. Then what is the advantages of the flat belt conveyor? Okay, first, this operated over the long distance. Okay, I have told yesterday, I have given the example of the sugar factory. In the sugar factory, there are belt conveyor are required to transport the sugar to Godown. Then we are operated over the long distance, 1000 meter or 1 kilometer. Okay, then what is the second advantages? You can easily adapt to natural contours of the ground. Means what? We can refer the general shape or outline of the object. Okay, you can check. Because of low frictional characteristics, flat belt conveyor required low power for the operation. Okay, there are some having the characteristics, low frictional characteristics. That's why flat belt conveyor required low power for the operation, very low power. Then this is a belt is a light in weight and have a simple construction, very simple construction. We have seen the construction. There are only 13 parts are there. With the help of that, we can construct the flat belt conveyor. Okay. light in weight and have simple construction, then require the minimum maintenance. Most important advantage is required minimum maintenance. Then what is the limitation or disadvantages of the flat belt conveyor? This is a highly stressable under the load. If you apply the maximum load, then this will be stretch. Okay, means you will get the ground clearance again low, or material will be unbalanced. Okay, this flat belt conveyor is unsuitable to take impact loads. Okay, because of when you impact on the belt, then they will be stretchable or highly stretchable. Okay, that's why material will be unbalanced. That's why we can't impact adding the impacting load. Okay, this is the second disadvantages. Then third one, cannot be used for the elevated temperature. Okay, if there is a maximum temperature, then we can't use the flat belt conveyor. Okay, then fourth one, there is a always possibility of slip in flat belt conveyor. If there is a material is transporting, then there is a sometimes we'll get the always possibility to slip that material, okay, from the conveyor belt. Then what about the width and volume of the, there is again limitation of the carrying capacity of the belt conveyor, because if the material having the high width and high volume, okay, then we can't transport that material with the help of flat belt conveyor. This is the sum of the disadvantages of the flat belt conveyor. Okay, all of you getting? This is the first type of the flat belt conveyor. Then there are different loading method as given. There is a hooper based loading method is given, and traveling hooper. Okay, traveling hooper is there. They are travel over the belt. Okay, and we'll see what is the difference between the hooper based and traveling hooper or loading method in tomorrow lecture. Today we'll stop here. Okay, all of you getting the flat belt conveyor, how to use this flat belt conveyor? Today we'll stop here.